InLog expands video possibilities to take your creative expression further. Get far less oversaturated footage and reduce the risk of blowing out the highlights and losing information in the shadows, even for daylight landscape scenes with extreme differences between the brightest and darkest parts of the frame. InLog also gives you more room to color grade in post-production to create the exact look and mood that you want to achieve. In this video, following a video production workflow using the video file type of H.265 10-bit in InLog tone mode, we are going to introduce camera settings, shooting tips, and setting up InLog footage for color grading. Now we are going to start with the camera settings. First, we are going to select the video file type. Go to Video File Type in the Video Recording menu and select H.265 10-bit MOV, which is a relatively small file size but still suitable for color grading. Then, select InLog in the tone mode. Because of its higher dynamic range, InLog is recommended when you want more flexibility in post-production to fully color grade the footage. Next, set View Assist to On in the Custom Settings menu. When shooting in InLog, a low contrast image is displayed on the monitor, which can make it difficult to see if you're really getting the image you want. Setting View Assist to On allows you to apply a natural look on the display to get a better idea of the final image as you shoot. Next, we will set the ISO sensitivity. Go to ISO sensitivity settings in the video recording menu and set maximum sensitivity to 2000. Setting the upper limit of ISO sensitivity in advance will prevent the ISO from unintentionally increasing too high and reduce noise in footage. Next, we will introduce tips for when shooting in InLog. InLog is great for capturing rich tonal details in video, but you still need to expose your footage correctly to minimize blown-out highlights and blocked-up shadows. As InLog retains much more information in the highlights than in shadows, it is recommended to raise your exposure a little more than you usually do. You can use the waveform monitor and the zebra pattern displays to help you keep a close eye on your exposure as you make adjustments. If you want to display the waveform on the monitor, go to G16, Brightness Information Display, in the Custom Settings menu, and select Waveform Monitor. Then, go to G18, Custom Monitor Shooting Display, in the Custom Settings menu, and check Display 2. When Display 2 is selected, press right on the multi-selector to check Brightness Information. Now you can display the waveform monitor by pressing the display button when you're shooting video. While taking care not to blow out the highlights, carefully raise the exposure until the waveform gets toward the highlight end. If you want to make adjustments while monitoring the exposure with the zebra pattern display, go to G13 Zebra Pattern and Pattern Tone Range and select Highlights to display diagonal lines on areas where the highlights are blown out. When raising the exposure to be brighter, it is recommended to set highlight threshold to the default value or higher. Next, we will introduce using ND filters. As a good rule of thumb for video, you should set your shutter speed to be double that of your frame rate. It is recommended to use a variable ND filter, which allows you to smoothly adjust to a correct exposure without changing the aperture or shutter speed. The last shooting tip is regarding white balance. Unless you are shooting in RAW, you don't have the option to change the white balance in post-production. So it's important to make sure your white balance settings are correct at the time of shooting. For the most part, it's fine to shoot in auto. However, it's a good idea to pay attention to your white balance settings before you start shooting and adjust them according to your needs. Finally, we will introduce an exemplary way to set up in-log footage for color grading. We will run through the process using two different video editing softwares, Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve. Let's start with Premiere Pro. First, you need to change the color space. In the Project panel, go to Modify and select Color. In the Modify Clip window, set Override Media Color Space to Rec 2020, and then click OK. Now you're ready to start color grading in the Lumetri Color panel. Next, let's run through how to set up your footage for color grading in DaVinci Resolve. Create a new project. Go to File in the menu bar and open Project Settings. Open the Master Settings tab in the Project Settings window. Set the frame resolution and frame rate in the timeline format. Open the Color Management tab and set Color Space and Transforms. Select DaVinci YRGB Color Managed in Color Science and uncheck Automatic Color Management. Select SDR Rec 709 in Color Processing Mode. Select Rec 709A in Output Color Space. Click Save to close the window. Open the Media page and add video files that you want to color grade to the Media Pool. Open the Edit page and add the video files to the timeline. Now you are ready to color grade your footage on the color page. The steps we introduced in this video are just for reference purposes. It's always good to find a process that best fits your own workflow. Shooting in InLog gives you a lot of flexibility in post-production and lets you deliver videos with exactly the look and feel that you wanted.